Hey everybody, Brian from Behringer here. We are at NAMM 2013 and speaking with Jan Duwe from our German office. He is one of the core or chief designers of the new X32 Producer, and he's here to walk us through it. So first of all, thank you Jan for joining us and walking us through this amazing new board.
Yeah, I'm happy to do so.
Right on. Well, first off, tell us how it maybe differs a little bit from the full-size X32.
Well, the full-size X32, as you call it, is well-established meanwhile, so you can use it in lots of different applications. People are using it in their homes, you can run large theater productions, large shows, and that's where it's real places, where you need all the functionality at your fingertips, lots of controls, lots of information. But what would you do if you have, you don't have the space around and you're not operating directly on the console, but rather remotely? You're taking your iPad to go to the spot where you can listen, or walk around the stage to set up the monitors. You're far away from the console. So the question was, why would I need all that infrastructure and the real estate on the console? If the console is hidden somewhere and I cannot really access it. So for those applications, we had to come up with a solution that is really compact, affordable, and remote controllable, that still allows the same workflow and the same user interaction as on the large console, but of course sacrifices small bits here and there without losing the performance overall. So we still have the same processing, we have the same channel count, the same number of effects. Everything is just the same, so you can exchange scenes from a real big X32, put it into the X32 producer, and you're up and running immediately. So the real cool thing about it is now we found a solution that is really rack mountable, 19 inch. You still got, I can show you the workflow maybe. We still got the separation of input channels and group channels, all motorized faders obviously. We still have metering in all the channels. We have a channel strip. We have a very nice display showing all the details. So that's all in common from the X32. What you actually miss is LCD scribble strips, is things like the scenes controls. We still have scenes controls and we do have mute groups, but they are on the display here. So I can still run 100 scenes just the same as on the X32, but I don't have the dedicated controls anymore, obviously, because it has to fit somehow into the 19 inch format. So there's not any sacrifice on functionality, it's only some compromise in the physical layout. That's the only thing. And this makes this product so attractive in my eyes, because it's extremely portable. It's much cheaper than the large X32. So whenever you need something that is hidden somewhere else maybe, or you don't need the full size form factor, then this really makes sense. And the good thing is also, since it is fully remote controllable, you can use it in large venues, put it somewhere, but you can also take it home or take it to a rehearsal and make a live cut during a rehearsal. So everything is possible. You still have the 32x32 channel audio interface, you have the AES50 interfacing, networking with the stage boxes, you have the P16 output. So none of that is sacrificed for the smaller form factor or for any budget constraints, if you wish. So basically everything's in here, but just some knobs are missing, which could make sense in a large, when you're doing large venues regularly, then obviously you want a large console with lots of controls at your fingertips. There's the compromise, and that's the difference actually.
So it sounds like they really speak the same language, they have all the same firepower, all the guts, if you will, of the big one, but now you've got this very, very portable, very powerful tool that can be used across many locations a lot easier than lugging the big guy.
Yes, absolutely, that's it. So that's why we call it Producer, because in our eyes, for our customer base, I mean, I'm not talking about the million-dollar producers, but our customer base, when they think about producing, they have to be flexible. They have to be able to know their tools very well, so familiarize themselves with a specific workflow, and then know exactly how to do things. They can do that at home. They can prepare things, they can do post-production on their own DAW, and they can take it to rehearsals or live shows. It's a huge flexibility.
Yeah, and you get the same recall of the scenes, and you get, you know, the ability to design your sound ahead of time, show up, connect everything, and your workflow is that much faster, right?
That's it.
Well, thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate you walking us through the producer, and we'll see you in the next video.